let me start, let me steal you some moments to talk about a game we just released today. But before, I would like to also know if usually you get mad at things like I do. I have a very nervous temper, so I tend to get very mad at people. You will be thinking now, why is this guy talking about this? Well, you'll find why later. Before that, let me just talk a little bit about myself. This weird guy here. I'm from Spain, from a city called Valencia, famous for the oranges. I work at Square Enix, but not as internal staff. I'm freelancer there. I've been translating games for 10 years over there. So there was a time when I got tired of it. I wanted to create my own games, stories. And not only that, I wanted to live to Akihabara. I wanted to be in the middle of the geek culture and to get influenced by all the creators that usually spend time there on weekends, especially buying retro games and all this. And even though I'm a very, you know, radical otaku, I still have a lot of friends and I come to events like this. So feel free to talk to me later if you want. I won't run away. So what happened last year? Last year, because of my work at Square Enix, maybe you recognize the building over there, it's very huge. But I want you to take your attention to this crossroads over there. I was living a little bit farther, exactly there. It was, Rokuchome is called the area. So there was a hospital, there was a police station, there was also the firefighter station. So every 5 minutes there would be a siren. You know. Preventing me to get some sleep at night. So just imagine after 10, 12 hour work, I will go back home, I will try to sleep. It was impossible. I wanted to give somebody some sleep. So I had to do something. Since I cannot kill people in real life, you know, I will go to jail, I won't be here today. I decided to put all my feelings, all my anger into a game. And that game is called Basso Crash. Basso Crash starts by an angry bear that has an array of weapons, a bazooka, a gauss, and a rifle. And basically what he does is just shooting all the energy cars, all the flashy cars that are 35 minutes. Yeah, make them explode, kill them, man, seriously. Even though I played this game 1,000 times, I still didn't have enough. So yeah, as an indie developer, you see that there's always like a very personal view on all the things we do. So I can't really tell that this game has a lot of me inside. The way you play it basically is just you try to avoid that the sleep level decreases so you cannot sleep anymore and you have to spend another horrible day until you can go back home and try to sleep. And it follows the daylight cycle. So the goal is getting to the morning, killing the maximum number of cars possible, and get some rest. By the way, in the background, it always plays the Bolero of Ravel because I thought that it really matched well the intensity of the game. It goes in crescendo, and in the end, when there are more cars in screen, the Bolero just goes crazy, and it really fits well the purpose of the game. So this is Basso Crash, and yeah, this morning I wake up, and I thought, why not release it today? Very chill, it's going, because there's only one stage that lasts 7 minutes as the Bolero. And if the game goes well, I will develop the second one, which will be set in Akihabara. You will be shooting at the Maid of Dreaming and all these Maid of Kisasons and the Mario Kart. It just has to happen one day. So yeah, quickly, let me tell you what I've been doing so far. Because I take a lot of personal stories into my games. The first one was called Tokyo Super Night. And there were the stories of rejection of several nights going out to Shibuya trying to get a Japanese girlfriend. The second one, Boy of Spain, I like a lot Hide and Seek, it was my favorite game when I was a kid. So it was just natural that I was very into Metal Gear Solid later. So I just changed a little bit the design of the stealth games and made it happen inside a farm. And now at the same time, we've been forever developing an RPG that takes a lot of influence of Falcom games. I'm a big Falcom fan, I like his saga, I like Ikikaikai, I like also Zelda. So it takes a lot of influence. And yeah, it will be released one day in the future, hopefully. But not only that, since I've been 10 years working there at Square Enix, I really like RPGs, and we're assembling a big team now. I thought, yeah, why not going all the way professional and assembling, you know, like a better team. And getting some funding and going all the way. So that's also in the plans for the future. Yeah, it's developing a big RPG that I can feel proud of it one day. And that was all, sorry, it took so long maybe, but that was all about it. Thank you very much for your time.